Hello guys, you all are welcome in once again in my channel. Today we are in this lecture I'll show you what are the various different opportunities in the front of you all guys, where you may say the various top 10 technologies right now in which the world is roaming about, and where you have a maximum chance to get a job. So stay tuned and watch this video till end. At the end of this video you are able to learn about the various top 10 technologies which are right now available in the market, and I'll advise you to just keep on working on these technologies if you want to get a good job in future. So stay tuned, without wasting time let us start this video.
Very often we came across few words which are very common to right now, very common to all, but we assumed whatsoever we learned half, we assumed that it is just like that, but actually the things are not exactly the same that we thought. So today I will come up with what are the top 10 advanced technologies used nowadays in a world, and these technologies and where you have to work in the future. I know you are the second year students, so this is the right time to to learn these technologies here, so that you can choose your area of work, area of your research, so that you can do first of all you have to aware about the technologies, what are the technologies, then you can choose this as your career in your future. So without which I categorize how I arrange my lecture, I basically categorize these technologies as a countdown from 10 to 1. So I will show you and explain each and every technology to you. So maybe you know these technologies, but whether you know how they are categorized or they are adopted in the market. So let us begin with the first one. The very first one is top 10 at the number level 10 is RPA. Now what is RPA? RPA is a robotic process automation. Robotic process automation is, since in this lecture most of the students are from CSC background as well as the EC background, you have to understand this. Right now the market is now going on changing very rapidly, and the technologies that we use earlier, like an embedded system and for making remotes and everything to make websites, we required a high level of coding. But nowadays these everything's get automated, and the technology which is really behind that is what we called RPA, robotic process automation. And robotic process automation means in every office all the works nowadays they are done automated by the computers or the machines. First of all, one of the most important feature of this RPA is that no coding is required for that. Just for doing RPA, robotic process automation, you need not to be learn any kind of coding. There are just drag and drop kind of blocks are there, you just have to connect them. So it is very easy for those who are not coding enthusiast, those who are not like coding, do coding, so they can choose their career in RPA. Now RPA, it basically whatsoever the repetitive task, it now get over through the help of RPA, and definitely there is a cost saving, because earlier to do a particular task you have to spend most of the cost on the manpowers, but all the manpowers nowadays get replaced by this robotic process automation. And what are the various top three tools? Now first of all you have to aware about what are the tools we have to learn if we want to work in this area, in robotic process automation. If you want to work, you have to be aware about these tools like UiPath, Blue Prism and Automation Anywhere. These are the tools. So I request you all to to just go through these tools, at least you have aware about these tools. One of them are I think Blue Prism and UiPath, they have a open source kind of, they will give you a free trial to do the task on their environment. So if you appear for an interview in any company and you say I am an expert or I am a beginner in the RPA, So you must have to aware about what are the tools which are, you know, going on in RPA. That are UI Path, Blue Prism, and Automation Anywhere. And I request you all to just go on the Google and search about these tools and try to, you know, download it or do some sort of practicals on this, so that you are aware about how this RPA works and what are the top companies. This is very important. What are the top companies which are, you know, working in this area RPA? Deloitte, IBM, Intel, Dell, they all these are the top companies which are right now they are processing in the field of RPA, robotic process automation. So the only thing that you have to learn about the RPA is here is RPA is a robotic process automation which is, you know, replaces all the human tasks happening in a certain office. Like if we take an example, like in an HR office, you know, he has to be manage the leaves and everything, manage the leaves and you have your salary and your attendance, everything. So these all tasks, earlier it was done by 2 or 3 persons, but nowadays these all the tasks are automated. Like an Excel sheet, if you make the automated Excel sheet by applying the formulas, if you enter somewhere something, then the other things are automatically, you know, calculated itself. Similarly, if in your college, if you do a automation, then the scheduling of the class, your preparation of your, you know, fee receipt and everything can be done automated. There is no man requirement. Now maybe you have a doubt. You have a doubt if RPA do and everything, then it will cut off, you know, jobs opportunity for the others. Yes, definitely. In the coming, you know, year, there is a cut in the jobs, like the clerical jobs, it will cut. But definitely on the other hand, you know, some high skilled jobs will be available in the market. So you have to understand the process of the automation, how it is, it can be done. And the beauty of this is no code is required. So most of the students, those who are, you know, beware about the codes, they think we don't do the coding. So this is an opportunity for them to, you know, work in this area. RPA is one of the most important area and it comes under number 10. See, it is important, but still this technology is at number 10. So let me quickly move towards the next one. 9 number. Yes. This is an intelligent app. What are the intelligent apps? The intelligent apps, you know, the app which, you know, respond to your query itself, like a chat bot and virtual assistant. They are what we call intelligent apps. So one can see intelligent apps as the appliance of the artificial intelligence and the advanced machine learning in the form of the application. So applications like chat bots and virtual assistants. So this is also right now very, you know, promising in the market, intelligent app, to develop the intelligent apps. And the basic companies which are working in these fields are Oracle, Google, and Salesforce. You must have to aware about this name, you know, Salesforce. It is one of the top company in the computer science right now. And most of the, you know, market share it captures after Google and Oracle. This is the third largest, you know, company in the field of IT. So Salesforce, Oracle, and Google, these are the companies which are right now, if these are your dream companies, so you must have the awareness, not only the awareness, you have a, you know, something practical in hand with you. For this, I'll advise you to, you know, Google has one of its platform of designing a chatbots or virtual assistant, that is Google Chatbox, like that. This is available in the on a Google. I'll advise you all to, and it is free of cost. I'll advise you all to, you know, create your own chatbots on the Google AI. On the Google AI, it is a platform where you can design your own chatbots, a little bit, you know, like a demo chatbot you can design. So chatbot, it's basically, you know, it depends upon machine learning also and neural network also. Natural language processing we use in chatbots. If somebody asks some question to the machine, it will reply back. Like you find many of the things, many of the websites nowadays available, they are automated. If we're talking about the IRCTC or air ticket booking, if you go and book, want to book a ticket, then, you know, there are the chat box which will ready to help you out. If you have some general questions, they will reply back. So how this chat box is designed, it is very easy. You just have to know the set of the question that a particular person can ask, like how are you, and if it comes to the, you know, for a air ticket booking, definitely he will ask for the price or ask for the, you know, time period or anything. So for that questions, you must have to, you know, have an answer that machine will reply back. So this is very easy to design. If you have any, you know, if you want to work in this area, chat box on Google AI, you may consult me. I am also running, you know, one of the research group across the world, where most of the I have students from California, London, Australia. They are doing research with me. So I'll also invite, at the end of the lecture, I'll also give you a link and invite you, those who are really interested in doing, you know, start their career in these promising areas, you may consult me. I will ready to help you out, and it is totally free. But only thing is, I want some brilliant brains, those who can work with me. So let us move this. See, this is an intelligent app, is also, you know, very promising area, but still it is at the number 9. So what at the number 8, let us see. Number 8 is IoT. IoT is one of the name which is very, very frequently used nowadays everywhere, every, you know, article, every newspaper, you heard about this IoT. Now what this exactly IoT is, connecting everything enabled. First of all, let me explain what the people, general people think about it. IoT means life in everything, you know, life in everything. Now what it means, life in everything means, let us suppose you are sitting on a chair, then, and you are sitting for a last 8 hours, then your chair will, you know, respond you back. You know, like now it is very stressful, you have to take a rest, like that it will give advice to you. Similarly, it means the life in the chair. Now how to put a life in something? For that you need, you know, sensors. So if you have a sensor technology, if you have a whereabouts the 10 sensors, and you put it, a sensor is nothing but a kind of chip, if you put it on the chair, then the chair will, you know, after some time, by gauging the pressure, it will tell you that this is this for a how much long time you are sitting on that. So you just take and rest, like that kind of advice it will give to you. Similarly, your refrigerator, if you in your fridge or refrigerator you put the sensors, it will tell you like the milk is not inside, or bread is going to be finished, or eggs are you know, there is no eggs in the egg trays. So it will give you, you know, alarm on your mobile app, on your mobile, like because mobile is just like a gadget which is right now everybody have, and this is the one of the medium through which you get an information. So anyhow, IoT means life in everything. To embed the life in everything, what you need? You need sensors. So if you have a knowledge about the sensors, you can put the sensors across the devices, make them live, and you know, everything in a near future will get live. This is what we call Internet of Things, or life in everything. This is what similarly for a car, your purse, for anything that will have a life. They will tell you what they feel, everything. They can you know, give you an information on your mobile. The IoT is not a new field. We are working in this area since 2002, but still we are not able to, you know, make the complete IoT enabled atmosphere. Do you know why? This is because the only reason behind that is the sensor technology. Sensor technology is nowadays is very costly. It is very, very costly. So once we have this sensor technology cheapen, we have, you know, if we have this in a penny cost, then definitely we will have this technology available. Earlier we have one more problem with IPv4. Those who are computer science student, they can understand this better. IPv4 has a, you know, limited IP addresses. But as there is an advancement going on, and we have IPv6, where, you know, there is unlimited IP addresses. So IP addresses nowadays, it is not a problem. The only problem is with us, which is through due to which IoT is not get enabled, is that your sensor technology. The sensor technology, as in the near future, I'll predict, I also write a blog on this. By the end of 2025, maybe this IoT is fully feasible, because we are working very hard in the field of sensor technology and try to make it cheapen. So by the end of 2025, so this is the area where you can work very rapidly, this is a very promising area in which you will get a job opportunities. Now the many students have a question in their mind, how to start the work in IoT field. So I'll tell you, IoT is nothing but working on sensors and connecting the sensor with the mobile devices. So if anyhow you learn about the sensor technology, for sensor technology, what I advise you, you should have to go for Arduino, which is a microcontroller through which microcontroller through which we can connect the sensors, and through this Arduino we can connect to the mobile through Wi-Fi or through any communication protocol like Wi-Fi or Zigbee or Bluetooth, whatsoever. So you have to understand how to connect the sensors with the Arduino or the successor board like Raspberry Pi. If you I also have a channel where I put I'll try to demonstrate how to connect the Arduino with the sensors and with the Raspberry Pi, how the sensors can be connected. And if you want to get a more insight into that, I'll advise you all to just go to my channel and search about this Arduino and Raspberry Pi. There you can understand this in a better way. Although there are so many channels across the YouTube, but on my channel you can understand it in a better or in simplest way. So I think, but still, see, once you have a learning about this, so in the near future, you are going to be this will be helping you to get a job. So IoT is also one of the promising area, but still it is come under the numbers 8. So what are the remaining 7? Let us quickly move towards the next. So DevOps. DevOps is again a very, very important area. This is particularly what I think it is for computer science student. DevOps is earlier what we are doing, we create a website and we will take, developer will take 1 month to create a website, and after that they give it to the owner. Then owner will check it again and reply back to the developer that these kind of changes are required. Then again, this is a long process that earlier we adopted. But nowadays, DevOps is what? It is a software development strategy aimed to eliminate the silo. Silo means the time gap between the development and the operation. Earlier, you have to submit it, then owner will approve it, then you have to correct it. Now this complete process get one-sided, like live. Once the developer doing something, the owner is also seeing that whether it requires, like you put the header here, but the owner want to header a little bit lower, so he will immediately inform you while you are updating your code. So it helps you to do the task fast. So this is DevOps is a very important. Nowadays, it includes a continuous development. This is what we call continuous development, continuous testing as well, and continuous integration. This will save a lot of time of the developers, and the companies which are right now using it is Facebook. I think you all aware about these symbols: Facebook, Amazon, Netflix, Google, Adruka. So what I request you all here is, if you any of these companies are your dream companies, so you should have to start working in this field, DevOps. So if anyhow you got a chance to sit for an interview for a Facebook or an Amazon or a Google, they will ask you about the DevOps. If you have a understanding about the DevOps, then probably your chances of getting selection in this is better. So what are the features? Features are shorter software development life cycle, because everything gets checked immediately at a site, and it is better and improved work and team collaboration. And what are the popular tools if you want to work on DevOps? These are the tools mentioned here, like Git, Checksum, Puppet, Ceph, Docker, Stack. So these are the tools on which you have to make yourself get ready. at least I'll advise you to just, you know, open all of the tools once on a Google and search about that, how, you know, start, you can do a demo on projects on these tools. If you started working on this, definitely you will get recruited by these companies easily. Rather, you have a, you know, have a good chances of get selection in these companies. So still DevOps is so much promising, but still it is at the number 7. So let me move towards the number 6. Yes, number 6 is, again, it is for, you know, CSE and IT students, Angular and React. Now, what is this? Is a symbol of Angular and this is a symbol of React. You must have to aware about this thing also. It is a, one of the most popular, you know, technology also used in the market. Popular JavaScript based framework for creating modern web applications. You know, nowadays what will happen while presenting result, we need certain kind of features like speed and performance. We need certain kind of graphics like this kind of modular and native web development and open source. Like these features we want. So this can be very easily created with the help of Angular and React. And the companies which are working, which requires, you know, professionals who know the Angular and Erects are Google, Sony, Reddit. I think you learn, you have an information about this Reddit. Reddit is also a social marketing platform. And similarly, Netflix, PayPal, and Facebook. These are the companies. If you have experience in Angular and React, they will definitely recruit you. So quickly move towards the next one. Fifth one. Very important, cloud computing. And I think everybody, you know, from you are aware about this name, cloud computing. Nowadays, earlier, you know, what is happening earlier, we all have, you know, desktop or a laptop with certain memory, like one, nowadays it is 1 TB or some 2 TB or 5 TB. But cloud computing is what earlier, you know, this kind of infrastructure is, this is what we call infrastructure, like a laptop or desktop. This is what we call infrastructure. So for a whole campus or for a whole company, you required, you know, this kind of infrastructure for all. But and this infrastructure is very costly, nearly about 1 lakh for one system you have to build. And if you have a company size of 1,000, then you required 1,000 this kind of setups, which is very extremely, you know, costly. So with the help of cloud computing, this cost get cut out. How? You just need a computer which have an ability to deal with the internet, just, and so much, you know, TVs and RAMs are not required into that. You can do anything you want. Like if you want to do a lab experiment on MATLAB or anything, any software, you know, then the cloud, they all are, you know, available nowadays on a cloud. Cloud is a common server on which these things are placed. You can easily, you know, connect with these softwares available on the cloud. And this is, and earlier, you know, there is a job opportunities in the networking, but nowadays this networking field where, you know, the student of ECE or computer science, they do the Cisco kind of certification and get a job. Because earlier everything is, you know, connected by a LAN or MAN, so they are particularly work in this area. But nowadays this networking is get changed. Nowadays cloud networking is one of the promising area where you can have, you know, most of the jobs available. So cloud computing is one of the also area, and the features are, it is very fast and scalable, access anywhere. Yes, this is very important. Well, let us suppose this is a computer of Ajay Rupani, and next day he want to work on some another, you know, lab. So earlier what will happen, he has to go to the his system and then take his data from this system and go to the another system for operating. But nowadays what will happen, he do not have to store, you know, data on his computer. He has to, if he stores his data on a cloud, then he can access it from anywhere, not only from the campus, but from his home he can access this data. So cloud computing has this kind of feature that you can access it from anywhere. And it is very important for nowadays, like a COVID environment where we can access the data through the cloud while sitting at our home. Similarly, upfront cost is very low and it has a better security. This is very important. So, you know, everybody, okay. So let me ask you people one question. Okay. Let me ask one question to all of them. Whether you used cloud computing in your field, anybody? क्या आपने कभी cloud computing use किया? Anybody who want to give an answer? किसी ने कभी cloud computing use किया? No, okay. See, this is probably I will get the same answer, you know, from each and every student. But I'll you know want to tell you one thing. This is a question which we generally ask in the when we go for an interview to an any company or to recruiting students. We ask them whether you use cloud computing. So most of the students say no. But you know everybody have a Gmail account. Everybody have a Gmail account. I think the guy who respond me whether you have a Gmail account or not. Yes. So Gmail is what you are using cloud now. If you have a Gmail account, you are using cloud computing. So if you say no, we don't have an experience of cloud computing, then your answer probably is wrong, because Gmail, everybody have a Gmail account, and for Gmail you are using the cloud of Google. So you must have to aware about this technology. This is very important, cloud computing. And you know, the company, there is a cloud wars nowadays. Cloud war is means all the companies, they are look for the cloud. Cloud is nothing but the server, the space, the web. So Amazon, Microsoft Azure, Salesforce, IBM, Google, these are the futuristic, you know, very 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 you may say they are the bosses of the IT company. You can, if you want, these are your dream companies and you want to place into these, so you must have to, you know, start working in the area of cloud computing. And it is very easy. So what are the softwares which are used for cloud computing is the AWS. You can explore this Amazon Web Services. For this, they will give you, you know, credit to all students. They will give credit of few dollars. You just have to create your account with your credit cards and you can explore it for a year or a 2 year. They will give you a certain credit through which you can use it, you know, free of cost. Similarly with the Microsoft Azure, it has the, if you create an account, but the only thing, yeah, The only thing required is you have to log in with your credit card on these web servers. Then they will give you certain credit to explore these, you know, tools for you. So I'll advise you all to start working in this area also, Amazon Web Services. And if you want to require a more knowledge about this AWS and the Microsoft Azure, you can connect with my channel where I also, you know, put some videos regarding how to, you know, get start working on cloud computing or machine learning on Amazon Web Services and Microsoft Azure. So if this is one of the very very important area, and here still this is the area where no coding is required. This is the beauty. No coding is required. No hard coding like C++ you learned. No coding, such coding is required. You have to just manage it like a servers, but these all are virtual. Earlier you have routers and switches, and hubs. You have to, you know, learn about switches, hub and routers, how they works. But now in today's environment, they all are virtual, but they act like a, you know, physical real things. So this is again one of the most promising areas. This is at the number 5. So quickly move towards number 4, big data. Yes, big data is one of the area which this is a name which is heard by everybody, big data. And they are everyone, you know, nowadays they are talking about the big data, but they do not know what exactly the big data is. So big data is a term of the collection of the data sets so large and the complex that it becomes difficult to process using on hand database system tools on traditional data processing application. So how this is the kind of big data. Now you know how this big data create, who create this big data? We all, you know, create this big data. We all are the responsible for creating this big data. How? I will tell you. We all, you know, nowadays very active on the social networking sites like Facebook, WhatsApp. So what we are, someone, you know, वो लोग क्या कर रहे हैं? कुछ लोग फटाफट से कोई म्यूजिक की फाइल भेज रहा है, कोई फोटो भेज रहा है, कोई कोई डाटा एक्सेल की सारी फाइल भेज रहा है, कोई डॉट डॉक्स भेज रहा है, और कोई म्यूजिक फाइल भेज रहा है. तो ये सारे कोई JPG भेज रहा है, बहुत सारे एक्सटेंशन है. ये सारे के सारे एक जगह जाके गुंजल बन गए हैं. ये सारे के सारे एक जगह जाके स्टक हो गए. अब क्या है, क्या इसको इसको हम बिग डाटा का नाम दे दिया है। अर्लियर नहीं था ये, 2000 से पहले नहीं था। क्यों? क्योंकि 2000 से सन 2000 साल से पहले हमारे पास इंटरनेट का एक्सेस नहीं था। ये जो बिग डाटा की प्रॉब्लम होनी शुरू हुई है ये 2010 से होनी शुरू हुई है, व्हेन एवरीबॉडी हैव यू नो स्मार्टफोन्स विद देम, तो और व्हाट्सएप आ गया, फेसबुक आ गया, तो सारे सब लोग इसके ऊपर हर लोग मैसेज करने लग गए। आज की डेट में आप देखो, एक सब्जी वाले से लेकर के एक एरोप्लेन चलाने वाले तक सबके पास स्मार्टफोन है। हर कोई जिससे भी बात करता है वो वीडियो कॉल करता है, कुछ करता है, तो वीडियो कॉल, एवरीथिंग, दिस डाटा यू नो गेट स्टोर्ड समवेयर। दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ बिग डाटा। सो अब आप कहोगे सर इसमें हमारे लिए क्या जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज है? यहाँ पे आपके पास जो जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज हैं कि आप बिग डाटा को रिजॉल्व करो, क्योंकि यू नो ये एक तरह की इंफॉर्मेशन है। बिग डाटा से इंफॉर्मेशन निकालो, वो इंफॉर्मेशन कैसे निकलेगी? जब आप इस डाटा को सबसे पहले तो अलग अलग करो, आप जेपीजी फाइल अलग करो, डॉक फाइल अलग करो, जितने एक्सटेंशन है, एमपीजी, एमपीजीपी, जो भी जितने भी एक्सटेंशन है आप सबको अलग अलग करो। वो कैसे होगा? उसके लिए हमारे पास एक टूल आता है हडूप। नाउ हडूप क्या है, जो ईसी के स्टूडेंट है वो इजिली समझेंगे। हडूप जो होता है एक काइंड ऑफ फिल्टर है, एक काइंड ऑफ फिल्टर है। फिल्टर क्या करता है? फिल्टर इन चीजों को अलग अलग कर देगा। बड़े आसान है इसको, हडूप को डिजाइन करना इज वेरी इजी। आप एक फिल्टर डिजाइन कर दीजिए जो जेपीजी की फाइल को अलग कर दे, उसको अलग कर दे, उसको अलग कर दे, तो वो क्या करेगा, एक लूप चला देगा जिसके अंदर वो सारी फाइल्स को चेक करेगा, पीडीएफ को अलग कर देगा, जेपीजी को अलग कर देगा, सबको अलग अलग कर देगा। दिस हाउ यू नो बिग डाटा कैन बी, पहले एक स्ट्रक्चर फॉर्म में आ जाएगा कि हर चीज अलग अलग होगी। अब अलग अलग होगी तो उसके बाद आप इसके ऊपर एनालिसिस कर सकते हो, कुछ भी कर सकते हो आपके हेल्प के लिए। तो आपको पता है जो आजकल एरियाज हैं जिसके अंदर ये बिग डाटा सबसे ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम कर रहा है, वो है रिटेल का एरिया, इंश्योरेंस का एरिया, करोड़ों की जनता है, लाखों करोड़ों अरबों की जनता है, उन सबको, इन सबने इंश्योरेंस लगा ले रखा है, तो इंश्योरेंस का डाटा को कैसे मैनेज करना है और उनको कैसे उनकी फाइलों को अरेंज करना है, ये इंश्योरेंस सेक्टर के अंदर बिग डाटा एक बहुत बड़ी प्रॉब्लम है। तो यहाँ पे ये बड़ा काम हो रहा है इस एरिया में। सिमिलरली हेल्थ फील्ड, हेल्थ केयर, आपने देखा होगा मरीज जब जाता है हॉस्पिटल के अंदर तो उसकी कई सारे टेस्ट हो जाते हैं, कई सारे रिकॉर्ड है, उसका बिल है, फलाना, बहुत सारी चीजें हैं। वो एक मरीज की बात कर रहा हूँ, एक मरीज के साथ कम से कम 1000 फाइलें हैं, तो ऐसे करोड़ों मरीजों के साथ पता नहीं कितनी फाइलें हैं, तो उन फाइलों को अरेंज करना, ये भी एक बिग डाटा का एरिया है जहाँ पे ये बिग डाटा प्रॉब्लम क्रिएट कर रहा है और इस एरिया में हम काम कर रहे हैं। सिमिलरली बैंकिंग एंड फाइनेंस, बैंकिंग एंड फाइनेंस में क्या है, SBI आपने देखा बैंक है, कोई भी एक बैंक ले लो, उस बैंक के अंदर कितने यूजर हैं, कितने लोग उसमें से ट्रांजेक्शन कर रहे हैं, कोई इंटरनेट बैंकिंग यूज कर रहा है, कोई मनी को ट्रांसफर कर रहा है। आजकल तो और ज्यादा प्रॉब्लम होगी, लोगों को 10 रुपए भी देने होते हैं तो वो अपने पॉकेट से नहीं देते, वो क्या करते हैं पेटीएम कर देते हैं, बैंकिंग से ट्रांसफर करते हैं। सो दीज आर द यू नो एरियाज वेयर द बिग डाटा हैज अ प्रॉब्लम एंड द कंपनी विच आर वर्किंग ऑन दिस इज एंड द टूल्स दे यूज इज दिस स्पार्क, Candera and Abase. So these are the tools which are, you know, which are on through which we can work on big data. So I'll advise you also to, you know, explore tools which through which we can operate on a big data. So this is an also a promising area, but it is number four. At the number four, still we missing three technologies. Number three, it is AR and VR. This is again a very important technology nowadays. And you know, several work is going on in this area. Virtual reality. Virtual reality is an artificial that is created with the software and presented to the user in such a way that the user suspend belief and the accept it's in the real environment. Like आपने देखा होगा पहले हम लोग जिम जाते थे, जिम पे वो करते थे, हमारे पास जिम पे इंस्ट्रक्टर होना चाहिए। Nowadays what will happen, you know, there is a VR in the front of you. अगर आप दौड़ रहे हो तो आपको ऐसा लग रहा है आप रियल रोड पे दौड़ रहे हो, तो आपको एक फील आ रहा है कि यार मैं तो रोड पे दौड़ रहा हूँ और मुझे ऐसे ट्रैफिक को वो कर रहा है, तो आपको एक ये दिस विल क्रिएट यू नो एंथुसियास्ट इन यू योरसेल्फ एंड नॉट ओनली एंथुसियास्ट योरसेल्फ दे विल यू नो मेक योर मूड। तो ऐसे ही आपको देखा होगा VR आज के डेट में गेम्स, आपने देखा होगा बड़ी सारी गेम्स ऐसी हैं, जैसे एरोप्लेन चलाना है तो यू कैन टेक अ फील ऑफ यू नो ऑफ अ पायलट, how he fly a aeroplane, you can take a feel of that also. So virtual reality for this, the Unity is one of the platform where the people are working. So Unity ke bare mein aap padhiye thoda sa, aur gaming ke jo tools hain like Scratch, and there are so many. And what I advise you to, if you want to make your career in this field, you must have a, you know, knowledge about the tools which are used in this area, AR and VR. So you just go and explore. This is also one of the most, we may say, that is a very good area where the students right now they start working. So this is very important. Again, to talk about more on AR and VR. AR is augmented reality and VR is the virtual reality. Augmented means you know something which is created by augmentation of several things, means the clubbing of several things. That is what we call augmented reality. I will give you an example. Like, let us suppose in medical field we have very limited number of doctors, expert doctors. So let us suppose a doctor is in America and he want to do an operation in India. So through the help of AR and VR this is possible nowadays. वो वहीं से इंस्ट्रक्शन देगा और जहाँ पे वो रोबोटिक्स जो है वो वहाँ पे अपनी आर्म हिलाएगा, उसको ऐसा लगेगा कि मैं मरीज को के ऊपर ऑपरेशन कर रहा हूँ और वो यहाँ पे सेम टू सेम वैसे ही वो मशीनें जो है एक्ट करेगी. सो दिस इज अगेन वन ऑफ द प्रॉमिसिंग एरिया और आने वाले टाइम में यही एक एरिया है जिसके अंदर आपको बहुत अच्छी जॉब्स मिल सकती है. सो दिस इज बट स्टिल इट इज नंबर थ्री. सो वट अबाउट द नंबर टू एंड वन? सो लेट मी मूव टूवर्ड्स द नंबर टू. Number two is a blockchain, very important area. This is also one of the very, very important technology. Blockchain, आज की डेट में जितना भी डिजिटल ट्रांजेक्शन हो रहा है, तो हम लोग पहले हम डरते थे डिजिटल ट्रांजेक्शन करते वक्त. लाइक पेट्रोल पंप पे हम अगर पैसा दे रहे हैं तो हमें लगता था कि यार कभी ऐसा ना हो कि पैसा कट जाए और पेट्रोल आए ना, या पैसा कट जाए और वो हमें जाने ना दे, वो ये कहिए मेरे पास तो पैसा आया नहीं लेकिन आपके अकाउंट से कट गया. So blockchain is for all the technical guys. What I explain blockchain in one word is it is a digital backbone. It is a digital transactions ka backbone hai. Uski reed ki haddi hai. But what it means? Dekho, आपको पता है आप जैसे कोई ट्रांजेक्शन करते हो तो उसका ट्रांजेक्शन का पर्टिकुलर एक आईडी होता है और वो पर्टिकुलर आईडी को ट्रैक करके आप ये भी निकाल सकते हो कि जब अगर ये सब चीजें डिजिटाइजेशन हो गया और हो भी रहा धीरे धीरे, तो आप कहीं पर भी कहां फ्लो आ रहा है आप उसको इजीली कैलकुलेट कर सकते हो. तो ब्लॉकचेन, अर्लियर द पीपल सेज कि ब्लॉकचेन जो है वो ज्यादा सिक्योर नहीं है, बट नाउअडेज इट इज वेरी सिक्योर. इट इज अ टेक्नोलॉजी बेसिकली विच इज बिहाइंड द सिक्योरिटी ऑफ योर डॉक्यूमेंट. लाइक द इन बैंकिंग सेक्टर, in healthcare sector, these are the areas where blockchain, right now we are using blockchain as a one of the area. और blockchain में हम करते क्या, it is just like a ledger. जैसे ledger नहीं होता, आपका बही खाता होता है जिसके अंदर आप credit debit statements लिखते हैं, it is just like blockchain is also like a digital ledger. इसके अंदर we can credit and debit, every information is there with a unique code. If that unique code, that is what we call hash key. That is what we call hash key. If you want to, since I have a very few minutes left for the completing this lecture, so I'll advise you, if you want to get a good knowledge about blockchain, I created one of the demo on my channel. मैंने इसके अंदर demo दिखाया आपको कि blockchain कैसे create होती है और वो कैसे काम करती है. तो आप उस channel पे जा करके उसको देख सकते हैं कि blockchain किस तरीके से काम करती है और इसके अंदर कैसे हम practically implement करते हैं वो भी दिखाया मैंने. तो ब्लॉकचेन को खाली नाम से जानना कि ये एक तरह का डिजिटल ट्रांजेक्शन का बैकबोन है और ये एक बड़ा सिक्योर्ड एटमॉस्फेयर है, इससे मजा नहीं आ रहा. आप क्या करिएगा, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट यू ऑल टू जस्ट गो एंड प्ले दैट वीडियो, यू कैन हैव अ मच बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ब्लॉकचेन देयर. सो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड डाटा स्टोरेज, हैश इंक्रिप्शन, दीज ऑल आर द फीचर्स ऑफ ब्लॉकचेन. सो बाय दिस अ ब्लॉकचेन कैन बी मेक अ हाईली सिक्योर्ड एरिया एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द एरिया वेयर यू कैन गेट अ job. So try to make yourself experience in this field, blockchain. So now we will move towards the last one but not the least. And can anybody guess what is the number one technology right now that we use in the market? Can anybody guess, have a guess, what is the number one technology?
AI.
Okay, what's your name? Deepak, I'll give you a gift. Definitely, I will send you a gift since you guess it right correctly. So I will send it through Ajay Rupani to you. Ajay, just note his name and his roll number. We will send him a gift. He guess it rightly. Artificial intelligence.
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
The artificial intelligence, it is one of the it is the area which is right and when it is developed. Let me start it from there. It is developed in 1945-46, or you may say 1940. We have a base in 1940 of artificial intelligence, and after that, after 1950, it is completely omitted from the world. They earlier we talked started talking about the artificial intelligence in 1940. At that time we have a we thought only we should have a thing like that through which we can talk, and the things through which, you know, respond us. But we do not, you know, we can't do not make it at that time. The reason behind it, at that time we do not have sufficient data. One thing, we do not have sufficient data that we have nowadays in a form of big data. Earlier we don't have this. And another thing is computation power. Computation power means, at that time there is no Intel processor, so no processor get designed there. But nowadays we have, you know, i5, i7, in fact more than that, i9 processors are with us. So this how the computational power is, you may say 100 times. But earlier we don't have computational power and the sufficient data. That's why AI loses its, you know, charm in after 1950. But again in after 2002, it again, you know, we started again in the working area in the field of AI. Why? And now in 2020, it is one of the best, or you know, you may say the promising area. It is just because we have a huge data with us. Earlier, see, artificial intelligence is what? To, you know, give intelligence artificially to the machine. So that is what we call artificial intelligence. You know, broadly, if we thought like a machine will speak like a human being, or it will act like a human being, this can be only possible if you put, you know, knowledge into the machine. And how we can put a knowledge into the machine? Definitely by, if we have a test cases, we have a data, we can feed it into the machine, and then the machine will be act according to that. So since earlier we are not have this kind of test data with us, that's why we are not able to. And otherwise, and also the computation processors we don't have at that time. That's why the early AI get failed. But nowadays we have a very big data with us, we have a computational power, and that's why we are able to, you know, design artificial, and Alexa and these chatbots are the real example. You know, Alexa is one of the application which is nowadays very famous in the world. Everybody have in their home also, they use and play with Alexa. It is a kind of bot which understand our language and respond back us. So this is what we call artificial intelligence. That's why artificial intelligence is at number one. And see the application areas where it is used. I don't think so there is any area left where we use artificial intelligence. But still, in education, in aviation, in retail, in finance, in healthcare, in heavy industry, everywhere nowadays we are using artificial intelligence. And you know, people are, most of the time they get confused. Nowadays the term artificial intelligence is not used frequently, but the deep learning and the machine learning, these are the words which are very frequently, you can see on the blogs on the Google, machine learning and deep learning. What is these? How they are different from AI? So for this, I'll post one lecture to you also. I'll request Ajay Rupani to send the lecture after this session, where you can understand, you know, what is the difference between AI, DL and ML. So here broadly I will explain you. AI is a, you know, big umbrella. AI is just like an umbrella, and deep learning and ML, machine learning, is the branches. It comes under this umbrella. It means AI is a big set, AI is a set, and machine learning, ML and DL, are the subsets. These are the subsets of the artificial intelligence. So if you want to, and this is one of the area where you can get a job. For this, you have to learn the machine learning. You have to make yourself experience in the machine learning. I have on my channel a separate playlist for the machine learning, where you can learn about how to, you know, get start your. But first of all, I give there is an introduction of machine learning, where I explained what are the various online and offline tools where you can do the machine learning, and after that how to start, get start on the machine learning. Everything is available on my channel. You can go and watch it. For the today's lecture, I'll end it up here by saying that artificial intelligence is one of the, you know, first, it is at the number first technology that everybody must have to have an information about this. So with this, I will give you my contact address. This is my email ID, techdoctorin123@gmail.com. This is an ID of my channel also, through which, and techdoctorin is my channel. If you have any query regarding the machine learning, artificial intelligence, and if you want to learn AI particularly, I daily posted, you know, one of the video lecture into it. You can just go and watch it. If you face any problem, you can ask me anytime. I will respond back through the channel itself. Or if you have some broad query, you can mail me. Or I'll give an opportunity to all of you. If you want to come and contact in my research group, if you want to become a member of my research group and you want to do some research on any one of the area, you can consult me. I will definitely see your profile. If it suits me, I will add you into my research group. So with these words, I'll close my lecture here. Or if you have, we will arrange a question answer session. If you have any query, you may ask me.